It is disheartening to note, after eradicating terrorism, after 30 years, the leaders and the forces which took part have been now accused of war crimes. I think this particular government, which is in power, is to be blamed. When certain charges were made at the United Nations Human Rights Council, the government did not object to it. They accepted it. And not only they accepted, they, with America, they brought a resolution to investigate and punish the leaders and the security forces who had been involved in the eradication of terrorism. If you turn around the clock to the 18th of May 2009, when the LTT were routed, defeated, there were a lot of people, groups, who did not like it. Some of them were the remnants of the LTT abroad. Then there were LTT sympathizers in Sri Lanka. And we had another group of Sri Lankans who never thought that the forces can eradicate the LTT militarily. These people, with the support of some of the governments, we tried their level best, even at the last moment when the LTT was trapped in Nandikadal, to save Prabhakaran. With their support, they managed to bring the war crimes label to United Nations Human Rights Council and label us. Lord Nesby, during his speech at the House of Lords, he categorically said his information that Sri Lankan government has not targeted civilians. Sri Lankan government has only fought the terrorists. And he said during the humanitarian operations, what he had studied, he said that the government took extra precautions in saving civilian lives. They fought with zero casualties in mind. And to blame security forces who have acted so responsibly is a crime, he said. And at the same time, he told the British government must influence, use its influence and withdraw all charges which have been made against Sri Lanka at the Human Rights Council. Who is Loard Nesby? Loard Nesby has been involved with Sri Lanka from 1975 as a member of the Sri Lanka British Parliamentarians Friendship Group. He has come to Sri Lanka many times. For 40 years he had associated us and he knows the problems what we have faced. He had come up many times in the defense of Sri Lanka. Once when Channel 4 was discrediting Sri Lanka, he found that some of those actors in that Channel 4 documentary were paid people from the LTT. He also found that the money collected by TRO, Tamil Rehabilitation Organization, went to the LTT, and he opposed permitting British collecting those funds in British soil, saying that it is double standard. The speech made by Lord Nesby at the British House of Lords had certain ripple effect in the British Parliament, America, and some of these Western nations who are bringing these charges against us, and of course the Sri Lankan government, who are guilty in accepting that our forces have made, had carried out war crimes. Now, what are these war crimes these people are talking about? They are talking about that the Sri Lankan government, during the last stages of the conflict, had massacred 40,000 civilians. They also say that the Sri Lankan government did not permit food and medicine to be sent to the areas which are under the LTT control to be used by the civilians. They said Sri Lankan government indiscriminately fired at hospitals. Now, if you take that point number one, where 40,000 people had been massacred, how can an army which went and rescued 300,000 civilians kept as a human shield, and an army who rehabilitated 12,000 LTTs who surrendered, can commit killing 40,000 people during the same period? Is there any logic behind this? At the same time, have these numbers had been collaborated with names and addresses of those people? Have they found mass graves in a era where technology is so advanced, where you can see through satellite anything which happens on land or anything which has been hidden on land? Is it possible? And why is the government of Sri Lanka accepted these type of allegations without opposing it? General figure which has been discussed by Loard Nesby, which he says the casualties should be around 7,000 to 8,000, has been obtained by his study, his investigations carried out by going into various statements made by various individuals. For instance, the ambassador to United States, Robert Blake, has said that during the last few weeks, just before it was concluded, that the total casualties so far has been about 4,000 to 5,000. Then he has been able to get whatever the messages which has been flying between the High Commission in Colombo and the government of Great Britain. And he had found that in none of those, the civilian casualties which had been discussed has been beyond 8,000. And that also, he says, that includes the LTT cadres who died. Therefore, agreeing on arbitrary charges, fabricated charges, this government has let down the security forces right royally, who fought and gave them freedom to move around. And I also see that Loard Nesby's statement has not been taken in the correct spirit. When somebody else, important person from another country, says that our country has not committed war crime, this first thing any government should have done was to send the High Commissioner in London with a bouquet of flowers and meet Loard Nesby and thank him. But it did not happen, and I did not see a resolution being discussed or brought in the Parliament of Sri Lanka. Why is not this government making use of this statement, which is of very importance to Sri Lanka? It says that after his findings, in the House of Lords in England, saying that our forces have not committed war crimes, and with statistics, with information, we could have easily convinced the United Nations, the Human Rights Council, to study this again and blame us only if they have concrete evidence that our forces have committed war crimes. And I do not know whether that will happen, because this government is entangled with some of these foreign governments which have brought this, and the groups in Sri Lanka and abroad who have been trying to target our forces. Thank you.